As a practical matter of fact, the easiest place to put it might be that corner over there.
Yeah.
And then we could start.
And then we'll figure out
this way. Yeah. So he's gonna go in and then get it up there.
Okay.
And then I wish I had rates and stuff. Hopefully this will inspire some
garbage.
Well, that any garbage we cover, we don't have to clean. So that's already part of how it goes. All right, that corner is the answer. That's the right answer.
They say this one has solar power.
So this is awesome. This is the first one, as you can see, this is the most creatively decked out one we've had so far. So, I mean, I gotta applaud you guys for not only doing the new design, but thinking of a way to make it a little bit different and cooler than the other ones. So, I like it. You can probably see, right, that the Andover Central School District basically founded this space because the city came up with the idea of a bunch of mud that people could live on. Zach and you guys came up with the idea of building this, which is Shelley number one. And that one, I think there were six students and a couple of dads and Mr. Warren, and the rain was coming down it was day just like today, cold and raining, and it's still there. And so we were just talking to you guys with the pandemic, owe us a year, so we'll have to make one more somewhere. You know, I mean, the Shelby 2.0 guys have been great. I mean, it's great for me that you guys are doing this, but I think this is the building of the future, and I think that learning some non-traditional building methods as well as how to frame out a house is pretty important, so the program is great. And you know, the fact that you're bringing it up here and you're thinking about us and our little project up here is awesome, because obviously there's other stuff you can be doing with your time, especially this time of year. And I would encourage you guys, like hang out. There's no one here. When we have to do here, everyone tends to just fade away because most of the folks here would rather not have to deal with all this. You feel free to walk around. Be careful of like what's on the ground and stuff. I wouldn't pick up anything. Just watch where you step. And as you're here, think about a few things. I would encourage you to think about the fact that inside of each one of these things that you guys are building, you now know the intricacies of the nuts and bolts and how it goes together. Now you can put yourself in a place with a person that's actually gonna be laying in it in February and January, which there are people in every one of these all day long. So, you know, take that with you when you leave here, because there's about the same number of homeless people in every part of the United States. The more people there are, the more homeless people there are, the proportion, the ratio stays just about the same everywhere you go. So I would be willing to bet that in Allegheny County, there are a lot of people that are desperately poor. Now, shelter may not be as much of an issue down there because people are a little bit, have different lifestyles and they're out of ways to live. But food insecurity and emergency, all of that exists kind of right in there back there. So just keep in mind that you don't have to come all the way around there. So it's a lot of issues that I don't have. But what's the place to be in the
we'll worry about leveling later.
Okay.
But
probably want to go
pretty much.
You want me to get in there, right?
Yeah. That is far into the corner on a 45. There's nothing to worry about around here besides needles and broken glass and stuff. And leave them here.
A little too sharp. Too sharp, roll it up!
Stop!
Follow back straight right now! Keep coming! Start cutting it!
Now you can start cutting.
Yep! Alright, keep following it back that way there, yep. Keep coming! That might be good right there.
Nice. You said this has solar power or something?
Yeah, I think the light.
Wow.
A little more! That should be good. Yeah, the lights.
So that's somewhere. Right there?
Yeah, I believe that's the charging panel, yeah?
Nifty. I live in a single wide trailer, so I know about tiny house living.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's popular nowadays. It's real popular. Is that a good spot for you?
That gives us a good starting. We owe the fire department 10 feet between the structures. So right. I think it makes more sense to start in the corner and then start working this way.
Sure.
And we might have access to some bobcats to help us do the booting. So.
Okay, yeah, definitely going to have to turn it. Yeah, I don't know if we can turn it once it's on the ground or not.
And that'll be position number one.
Beautiful.
Just in case it's like a fall.
Right.
So,
okay.
We'll tip it up. You guys just make sure it doesn't tip over. Got it?
Get out of the way if it starts to go.
Way and put everybody right that way and just push.
That might be a little bit, just the wildlife in that place might be a little more.
Yeah.
If
we all get on a, you know, a corner, everybody get on.
Oh, shit! I wouldn't push from this. This is water.
You gotta come this way, right?
Wait, come here. We need some guys.
Corner?
Go on three.
Thank you.
Fine job. Nice job.
Okay, Ted. I'll tell you what, you guys are can be come up and help me head anytime.
Nice deal. Very good.
That looked like a group.
There you
go. I'm going to look in here.
Can you all do that again? I didn't hear the camera.
Oh, no! We that can't do that.
Is
we're
the
union.
Off the other leg?
Yeah, I think about
it. Yeah, now I'll just do the scope. It's a scope camera anyway. So yeah, you'll have to do it. Zach, if you can get that corner back a little bit. It's not exactly
45 degrees.
You want to get a picture while you want to?
Yeah.
Come on, Mike.